In November 2022, OpenAI's ChatGPT burst onto the AI scene, acting as a catalyst for a significant change in the world of artificial intelligence. Despite the concept of AI not being new, the arrival of ChatGPT shifted the spotlight onto generative AI. This pivotal movement both fascinated and raised concerns. The astonishing ease with which this AI chatbot performed tasks was genuinely impressive. It could write code, create poetry, handle complex questions, and even excel in exams. It showcased the potential of AI, evoking admiration while also prompting discussions in the tech community. Just around 6 months after the introduction of ChatGPT, which was built upon the powerful GPT 3.5 language model, OpenAI took yet another noteworthy step by unveiling GPT-4. This version proved to be even more potent, intelligent, and impactful than its predecessor. However, the journey of innovation didn't stop there. Whispers about the impending arrival of GPT-5 began circulating, hinting at another stride forward. Concurrently, OpenAI has recently launched GPT-Bot. GPT-Bot's primary objective is to gather data for the training of GPT-5. It's designed to navigate the internet and collect text data from various web pages. This collected text data plays a pivotal role in enhancing the capabilities of OpenAI's advanced large language models, encompassing both GPT-4 and GPT-5. The incredible ability of ChatGPT to generate content originates from the extensive pool of text data collected from the internet by GPT-Bot. This substantial collection of information acts as the cornerstone for the models to understand and address user inquiries. If you're curious about how GPT-Bot decides which web pages to check and which ones to skip, there are rules it follows. It wants to make sure the data it collects is really good and respects people's privacy and rights. For example, it only looks at web pages that anyone can visit, not the ones hidden behind paywalls or logins. And it avoids pages that have personal info like names, addresses, phone numbers, or emails. Plus, it stays away from content that goes against OpenAI's rules, like hate speech, violence, or things that aren't suitable for everyone. Assuming you're a website owner and you'd prefer that GPT-Bot doesn't explore your site at all, you can certainly have that option. You can include a specific line in your website's robots.txt file, which will instruct GPT-Bot to avoid your site entirely. The line would appear like this: user-agent:GPT-Bot, disallow:\. This simple command informs the bot not to venture into any web page on your website. Alternatively, you can customize this to allow or block specific sections or pages on your site. For example, user-agent:GPT-Bot, allow:\blog/disallow:\private/. This instruction lets GPT-Bot explore only the pages of your site's blog section while avoiding the private ones. This bot carries significant importance within the AI community. It empowers OpenAI to accumulate more data, which in turn fuels the development and training of advanced large language models with enhanced capabilities. These models can achieve astonishing feats in natural language processing, such as generating text, summarizing lengthy content, translating languages, tackling complex questions, and so much more. The ongoing progress and advancement of this technology rely on the valuable data amassed by GPT-Bot, ushering in exciting possibilities for upcoming innovations, just like GPT-5. There's a point we should consider in relation to the launch of GPT-Bot. On one side of the equation, we have ChatGPT, which is somewhat frozen in time and lacks awareness of events beyond September 2021. To keep it current, it requires more recent data. On the flip side, there's a slight complication regarding how websites gain from GPT-Bot's exploration. You know how Google boosts website visits by displaying them in search results? Well, that scenario isn't exactly mirrored with ChatGPT. Unlike Google, which directs traffic to websites, ChatGPT takes snippets of information from various internet sources and creates summaries. The tricky part is that it doesn't exactly reveal where it got that information from. Now, let's have a chat about GPT-5. It's kind of like the superstar that comes after GPT 3.5 and GPT-4. Even though we don't have much information about it right now, there are some hints that give us an idea that OpenAI is busy working on it and might reveal it to the world soon. They did something interesting. They applied for a special name for GPT-5 at the US Patent and Trademark Office in July of 2023. This special name covers a lot of different computer programs connected to language and AI. At this moment, the folks at the USPTO are looking into it. Now let's dig into what GPT-5 can actually do. Imagine it learning from its older pals, GPT-3.5 and GPT-4. It might end up even bigger, more precise, and capable of handling more tasks. GPT-4 is already pretty awesome with its 175 billion chunks of information. But guess what? GPT-5 could be way bigger. Some people are saying it might reach into the trillions. That means GPT-5 might be able to remember and understand more things than any human can. And that's seriously powerful. Speaking of accuracy, GPT-4 has already shown impressive results across different natural language tasks and benchmarks. It's done really well in things like understanding language, generating text, and answering questions. But get ready for GPT-5 because it's anticipated to surpass these achievements. GPT-5 might take accuracy and fluency to a whole new level, creating text and speech that's even closer to human communication. When it comes to versatility, GPT-5 is primed to shine. GPT-4 is already impressive in its ability to handle various types of input and output, encompassing text, speech, images, and code. However, with the advent of GPT-5, its potential could soar to new heights. Imagine GPT-5 not only mastering multiple formats, but also extending its capabilities to broader horizons. Imagine GPT-5 seamlessly integrating with external platforms and tools like social media platforms, search engines, and even productivity applications like Microsoft Office. Additionally, our expectations are set for OpenAI to further refine its proficiency in comprehending audio and video content. This transition has the potential to be truly transformative, particularly for content creators who seek intelligent support in tasks like organizing video sequences and selecting appropriate background music. This captivating advancement would elevate GPT-5's adaptability, establishing it as an indispensable asset across diverse industries and applications. GPT-5 presents a curious question that sparks discussions. Can it reach the summit of artificial general intelligence, or AGI? To explore this, let's delve into the essence of AGI. Imagine AI that learns and understands like a human. That's called AGI. It's different from today's artificial narrow intelligence, or ANI, which can only handle specific tasks. AGI takes it a step further, where AI isn't limited to certain functions. The concept of AGI opens up possibilities for AI to become an integral part of our lives. Imagine this. You casually tell your AI chatbot that you're planning to make a pizza, and it takes charge. It smartly gathers the ingredients you need based on your food preferences and orders them for delivery even before you're back home from work. Let's take a moment to imagine a scenario where GPT-5 achieves AGI. Here's a breakdown. On the positive side, GPT-5 could enhance productivity and creativity by expediting AI tasks, thus freeing humans from repetitive jobs. This potential development could lead to progress in education, entertainment, and communication, offering tailored and captivating content and services. However, there are also potential risks. GPT-5 might disseminate false information, propagandize, or manipulate, thereby posing potential harm to society and core values. This could give rise to ethical concerns and moral dilemmas, challenging fundamental concepts like human self-worth, individuality, and freedom. Speaking of reports and speculation, there have been early indications and rumors suggesting that GPT-5 could achieve AGI by the end of 2023. The idea revolves around GPT-5 generating text and speech with such realism that it could be mistaken for human communication. Some even entertain the notion that it could handle any question or prompt just like a human. However, the consensus among most experts and researchers is that the possibility is rather remote. They believe that AGI is still several years away and that GPT-5 will confront substantial obstacles in areas like generalization, reasoning, common sense comprehension, and ethical considerations. I'm sure you're intrigued by this question. When will GPT-5 finally make its appearance? It's a challenging query since OpenAI has not officially announced a release date. However, we can attempt to offer some educated guesses based on the patterns we've seen with previous models. GPT-5 was introduced in November 2022, followed by GPT-4 in March of 2023, leaving a gap of roughly 4 months between them. If history repeats itself, we might witness the emergence of GPT-5 sooner than later, possibly even before this year concludes. Nevertheless, it's important to remember that these are mere predictions, not certainties. The landscape of AI is ever-evolving, and unforeseen surprises, or delays, could impact GPT-5's timeline. If you enjoyed this video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel for more AI-related content. Stay tuned for more exciting AI videos coming soon. Thanks again for watching.